続きまして王さんこと木原優斗さんによります月の求道者です。木原さん、よろしくお願いいたします。
皆さんこんにちは。沖縄県生まれ鹿児島県育ちの王さんこと木原優斗です。よろしくお願いします。僕の好きは海で泳ぐこと。辛いことがあったとき、1時間海に行ってぷかぷか浮いていると、それだけですごく自分の気持ちが解放されて楽になったことがあります。皆さんも好きなことをしているとき、モチベがめちゃくちゃ上がるという経験はないですか？僕の周りにも、この世界にも、好きなことややりたいことを最高に楽しんでいる人がたくさんいます。そんな人たちが増えていったら、自分自身も幸せで、世界中が笑顔で溢れていくと思いませんか？
思います。
皆さんも僕のスピーチを聞いて、何かを好きになることの幸せを一緒に掴んでみましょう。Have you found what you were thinking wanted to? Perhaps some of you have already discovered your passion.So, are you enjoying what you love? With confidence to the rest? Here, I will introduce two people who are enjoying their favorite thing with shining eyes. The first person is Shohei Ohtani, who is admired both in Japan and around the world, and is known as a two-way player. He is a unique player who always dedicated himself to baseball and can improve even after failure. In a previous interview, he said, I think I have the talent to work hard what I love. For me, that was baseball. And I feel very lucky to have fallen in love with it at a relatively early stage in my life. Even now,I always keep a bat and ball in my bedroom. So, when I think of something that might be good, I can go in front of the mirror and try it out. I think I have the ability to love it and work hard at it. His dedication and hard work toward what he loved.Have elevated the motivation of other players, leading to the Japan victory in the WBC. See, though the people who are enjoying what you love most bring a lot of smile around the day. The second person is my mother.She is a spontaneous person who immediately takes action whenever she wants to do. She has a deep love for nature, saying that nature envelops us with unconditional love. Her greatest form of healing is immersing herself in the great outdoor. She thinks that when she communicates with nature,Her senses become sharper, and his intuition is honed. This means that by pursuing what you love, you can also refine your sensibility, right? My mother also loves talking to people. She can easily converse with both close friend and stranger. During those times, her eyes sparkle and she is full of life. Because of this, many people gather around her. To me, she is truly a singer of what she loves. However, I think many Japanese people today at the consumable. What as a thing. And cannot confidently enjoy what they are. But because it's something they love, I want them to fully embrace and enjoy it without worrying about anything. The reason there are significant health and mental benefits to pursuing the hobby and passion, as proven by study and research. For example, increases physical activity, can extend healthy and spontaneous and help maintain body balance, and provide relaxation, among many other important benefits. Most important, it increases personal happiness. Mostly, currently, Japan ranks 51st in the world for happiness. So, to improve this ranking, we should be more confident in ourselves and proudly pursue what we love. I believe that our lives of people who pursue their hobbies and passion to the fullest are enjoyed. Until a second year of junior high, I doubted whether a life dedicated to one's passion could truly be fun. However, in my third year of junior high, when I transferred to the remote island of Kanaka, I was deeply saved by the presence of the sea and felt the deer. Hearing an enjoyable thing in life, like this experience, you never know when or where you will encounter something you love. So, let's all wholeheartedly dive into our passion from various angles and enjoy them. By doing so, you too can become a seeker of what you love. 僕たちはみんな好きの求道者。Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Ocean, for a very uplifting speech. I thought one of the things that you're talking about with Shohei Ohtani really touched on something I believe, that talent is not something you're born with. Talent is just something, it's being willing to keep doing something until you become good at it. And I think Ohtani proves that with baseball, you know, any skill, people prove that with language, with athletics, with arts, whatever it is. The people who succeed, who become good, that we call talented, are the people who don't give up, they keep trying. And I think it's also, your mother's a wonderful example for you of embracing what you love, and obviously that has helped with you, and you discovered your love of the sea through that. And I think you're right, I think, and it's not only Japan, I think this happens in America too. So many people are too concerned about what other people think. And they're afraid to embrace what they love. This often happens with adults too, like adults telling other adults, you shouldn't like this, or you shouldn't like that, or anything like that. Brandon talked about growing up liking Star Trek before. In a lot of places in America, people would tease him for that. For me, it was comic books, right? My parents were like, when I was reading comic books in high school, my parents were like, you shouldn't be reading those. Those are for kids. I still read comic books now, I'm 41 today. And it's something I love. It's something I've embraced. And I think the people who are afraid to embrace what they love are the people who get old very fast. And the people who do embrace what they love, they're able to stay young in their hearts and in their minds. And I think this is an important message. You know, embrace what you love, don't care what other people think. And the same idea, don't tell other people what they should love. I don't care about baseball at all, but I'm not going to tell Shohei Ohtani that he shouldn't like baseball because I don't. Your mother likes talking to a lot of people and being around people. That's terrifying for me, but I'm not going to tell her not to do it, right? And you love the ocean, right? I'm not going to tell you don't go in the ocean if it's not my thing. Embrace what you love and don't care what other people do and don't care what other people think. I think that's a very good message. Thank you.
学院長、コメントお願いします。
ヒントは違うんですね。これで、君海が大好きなんですよね。海に入ってて幸せ感じるんですよね。本当は日本人ほとんどみんなそうなんですよ。なぜか分かります。みんな彼らの世界では海に行くと言って海に泳ぎに行くとかビーチに行くとか言いますよね。日本の場合は海にお風呂に行くというですね、海水浴に行くというんですよ。 Take a bath in the oceanね、そんなのは言わないですよね、イングリッシュはね、まあ、ネイティブだけやな。テイクパーティーなオーシャンのテイクパーティー、そうこうですね、海水に浴びに行くとは言わないですよね。日本では海に行くことはそういうふうに言うんですね。海の民ですからね。だからそういう意味では、君は本当に海でお風呂浴びてるようなもんですよね。素晴らしいですよね。でも話してるように、日本人ってのは仕事民族だから、仕事民族だから遊びをあんまり良しとしない。ここが問題ですね。僕の欧米社会のアメリカ、イギリス、オーストラリアの友達なんか40、50になったらもうリタイアしてヨット買ってもう好きに遊んでますよね。なんでこの人たちこういうことできて僕らができないんだろう。もう僕はもうはるか年取ってるのに未だにここに座ってコメントして仕事してるんですよね。かわいそうだと思いません？趣味がないのかって、趣味だらけなんですけど、本当は。その趣味が全然できないですね。もうとても残念なんですけど、君の話を聞いて、ふっと、そういえば仕事はしてるけど、時々楽しいこともしてるなと。今日、佐藤さんという方、歯医者さんの奥様がいらっしゃるんですよね。久高島にお呼ばれして、そこでちょっとお話をさせてもらったことがあるんですよ。よかったですね。天国でしたね。佐藤さん、今のお話聞いてコメントどうですか？
久高島の素敵な海を映像で見せていただいて、私も本当に久高島が大好きなんですよ。で、自分の好きなものは知らない世界、知らない土地に行っていろんな人と出会うことが私の大好きなことなんですけれども、やっぱりそうやって、ね、自分の好きなことを見つけるっていうのはとても大切だなと感じています。気づかせてくれてありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。君は僕のお母さん、お母さんも本当にスピーチに出すっていうのは素晴らしいことだと思うんですね。大自然が好きなんですよね、お母さんもですね。だから君も大自然が好きなんですね。お母さん、自分の息子のスピーチを聞いてどれぐらいの感動されたのかちょっと聞きたいですね。
お母様、いらっしゃいました。